We all got in different ways. There was like a big audition process. But because I met these guys and started recording in the studio for something else, I didn't know anything about S Club at the time. And then I got a call a couple of weeks later saying, do you want to be in the band? You know, some of the other guys weren't experienced in acting as well, and some were. So we kind of all just played off each other, and I think that's what worked about it. We all had such a laugh. But you do end up turning into this exaggerated cartoon character of... Especially with a TV show as well, it kind of all moulded into one. Don't Stop Moving is my ultimate... favourite. And I remember when we went in to record it and when we'd perform it, it was just, everyone loved it so much, and I think that really came across. Every time I go to a wedding or I go somewhere, Reach will come on or Don't Stop Moving will come on, and they are good, they're undeniably good pop songs. A movie, three tours, five TV series, do you know what I mean? We'd really fulfilled everything we thought, we went as far as we thought we could go. We wanted to tell the fans first, before they found out any other way, so... But that was just really nerve-wracking. And I remember the gasp from all the kids in the audience, and for me, I knew I wanted to carry on with the music and be a solo artist, so I started planning what I wanted to do straight away. And then when S Club was finished, I took 2 weeks off and then got straight back into the studio and recorded LAX and the album. And I remember that week of release, I was up against the Black Eyed Peas, Where Is the Love, which was the biggest selling single of the year. So exciting. And then when it went in at number two, it was just so brilliant. It's just a case for me to grow as an artist and learn more and, you know, keep on doing it and keep growing and making good music.